Hi, my name is Andreas and I work as a Field Application Engineer at G&D. In our last video, we introduced our KVM over IP extenders and we talked about the difference between classic and IP. Today, we will discover our IP matrix, the Control Center IP. While the standard network structures handle the central routing of the KVM signals, the Control Center IP contributes the logic in the network. It optimizes the accessibility of all devices. In this video, we learn how easy it is to put a matrix into operation and get know some useful functions. As we learned in the first video, KVM over IP extenders can be used in a LAN without the need of dedicated point-to-point connection. You can enjoy further matrix functionalities here if you add our Control Center IP as the central unit. We use the same IP extender devices, so there's no difference on the CPU or CON side. The Control Center IP represents the central unit of the matrix system. It has a central HTML5 interface which we can manage all matrix tasks. G&D has taken the features of the classical matrix like push-get, cross-display switching, API control, user management and integrated them into the KVM over IP matrix. For the start, we have to enable the Control Center IP to manage all devices and thus provide the matrix mode. Thanks to the device finder, this setup is done very easy. Our Control Center IP has the ability to locate all G&D devices in the same network by sending a short broadcast. Of course, our KVM over IP traffic may also pass through routed networks. Devices from other network segments can easily be added manually. After that, a configuration packet is sent to the detected devices, which contains all important data for establishing a connection to the Control Center IP. This includes the target IP address of the CCIP, the use ports and the encryption. After the configuration file has been transmitted to the end devices, they give a short feedback to the CCIP and then we see how the CPU and CON modules appear in our web interface. As soon as the devices are connected to the Control Center IP, we can log in at our console, open the on-screen display and see the target list. It is now possible to switch from one CPU to another. We are now also able to switch between the different consoles by simply moving the mouse from one screen to the other. This is our cross-display switching. It's very useful for workplaces that need to have access to several PCs at once. You can benefit from many more matrix features. Of course, the requirements of the IP network are a bit higher in this scenario. In control rooms and many other matrix applications, a computer often needs to have been accessed several times. To avoid latency between two consoles, we use the so-called UDP-based multicast in our matrix mode. We will explain what this means in another video and we will also talk about the network requirements for larger installations. So, thank you for watching. If you like the video, hit the thumbs up button. And if you would like to know more about G&D and our KVM solutions, check the links in the video description or visit our website directly. Until then, bye!